Go back! Go back! No! Hey!
But then the most amazing thing happened. I landed next to an oil rig and they was hiring people. And what they paid was like a sign from above that I was meant to find my parents. Hey, man, you done with that apple core?
I'm done with that fart. You want that?
Maybe if it came out of Charlene Tilton's ass, I'd take a bite.
Yeah, you probably like JR, you queer. I saw your bumper sticker. Cowboy's butts drive me nuts.
Is that right? You think that's queer? Is this queer?
They're large and in charge and looking for chickies.
You want to back that up?
You want to fight? Why don't you stick your head on my butt and fight for air?
That's it. You and me. Let's go.
You know I would. I'd love to beat your ass up and down this place. I gotta go back to work.
Joe Dirt, you're fired. Here's your week's pay.
Luckily, my neck broke my fall.
You got 20 on it?
I guess you won the battle.
Yeah!
But I won the war. If you're covered in oil, don't stand next to a fire. Now that's day one stuff. Keep that skull, baby. That's what I'm talking about. So I had my 360 bucks. The next day I was gonna try the police sketch thing. Something happened in my head. See, I spent the night in what I thought was an abandoned circus tent, but I guess it was no circus. I was totally bombing insecticide, I think. So needless to say, I was in no shape to do anybody any good with my recollections. The guy doing the police sketch thought I was messing with him. Because my dad came out looking like Father Time, and my mom came out too butch, and looking way too much like Richard Ramirez. You know, the Night Stalker, remember that guy? As my head cleared, I realized I needed a different approach. Then I got a brainstorm. Hire an Indian tracker to help me, man. That's a great idea. They can find anything. It's like in the movies. So I headed for a reservation.
Want me to put my ear to the ground, listen for hoofbeats, check for footprints, look for broken twigs. But this is the modern age. That stuff doesn't work anymore, which is why I have to open this fireworks stand. I wasn't getting by on my tracking wages.
Come on, you're supposed to be good at tracking stuff, man. I gotta find my parents.
And I've gotta figure out a way to sell more fireworks. I'm going broke with this venture also.
Well, I see you got them snakes and sparklers, but where's good stuff, man?
Good stuff? This is the good stuff. Snakes and sparklers.
Are you nuts, dude? You need stuff to explode. Go boom.
Why is that good?
You might as well ask, why is the tree good? Why is the sunset good? Why are boobs good? Man, firecrackers. You stick them in mailboxes, you drop them in toilets. You shove my bullfrog's ass?
I would never do that, because I'm gonna be a veterinarian.
Well, there you go. Someone shoves an M80 up a bullfrog's butt, blows him to pieces. He comes back to you to fix it. You win twice, brother. It's good biz. So you're gonna tell me that you don't have no black cats, no Roman candles or screaming memes?
No.
Oh, come on, man. You don't got no lady fingers, fuzz buttles, snicker bombs, church burners, finger blasters, gut busters, zippity-doo-dahs, or crap flappers?
No, I don't.
You're gonna stand there, owning a fireworks stand, and tell me you don't have no whistling bungholes, no spleen splitters, whisker biscuits, honky lighters, hoosker do's, hoosker don'ts, cherry bombs, nips of dazers,
with or without the scooter stick, or one single whistling kitty chaser?
No. Because snakes and sparklers are the only ones I like.
Well, that might be your problem. It's not what you like. It's the consumer. Whee! Look at there. Oh, that's happening, man. We should get bleachers over here. People come from miles around to see this thing. Feast your eyes on a feast of smoke. Oh, dang, it's out. Oh, CNN's gonna turn around and go home now. What's going on, man? I saw a snail over there. He said, that thing's slow. It ain't moving fast. It's boring and dull. I'm yawning. That's a snail watching that.
There's a snail in the desert.
Yeah, a spaceship dropped him off. Don't focus on the wrong part of the story, brother.
And the snail can talk?
Yeah, because they gave him powers to aliens. They made his little voice box. Dude, I'm just saying, it's dull, all right? This ain't fun. Look at that little piece of char. You need explosions. You need stuff going on, man. No wonder this thing's going under. You got nothing. It's wussy stuff.
Well, I got these two sticks.
Oh, dang. These are yours? These are Roman candles, brother. It's good stuff.
This thing full of lighter fluid. Yeah. The Roman candle. Step back a little bit.
That's what I'm talking about.
It's beautiful.
Beautiful. I'm looking for righteously kick ass. You know what we need?
Gasoline. Yeah.
Breakfast of champions. All right, we might want to take a few extra steps back on this one.
Look.
Oh, man. What a trip over.
There's something metal sticking out of the ground. You okay?
What is this thing, man?
Maybe we should take it over to that place. The laboratory over in the next town. Los Alamos. That symbol looks very stern.
Yeah, man, that's definitely what we should do. That's the right thing. But first. Yeah, jam that in the gas bucket. We'll shoot fireballs at it. Yeah. We gotta step way back. It's gonna be fun. Woo-hoo! Look at that shit! Oh, man, we're gonna get so busted. Let's get out of here.
You tripped over that object in the ground. You're knocked out.
That thing's an atom bomb, man. I got an idea.